Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to do some new designs for scrunchies, and I'm thinking tie-dye because I have this one right here that I have on my website and my Etsy store, and it's one of my popular designs, and I have a lot more of these type of tie-dye designs that I want to try out. So I'm going to do that today, and I think I'm going to do a little tutorial on how to make your own fabric tags for your scrunchies. Now I did this on satin ribbon, and I usually, these are too big, these are actually 1.5 inches, so I don't use these for scrunchies, but you get the idea. I usually use 3/4 of an inch, which I ran out of, so I need to go to Hobby Lobby to actually get some more. My other stuff did not come in the mail yet, so we're just gonna buy them at Hobby Lobby. They come in rolls like this. You've seen them before, probably at craft stores. So I'm gonna, hopefully Hobby Lobby has the 3/4 inch satin ribbon. And what I usually do with my fabric tags is make them so that they match the scrunchie. So you got, you know, the fabric scrunchie and then the matching tag. So they don't really stick out that much. I think it looks better that way. But anyway, so let's get started today. Pretty good. I probably won't use all of them. I'm thinking just a few of these. So I actually didn't think I was going to like this green yellow color for a scrunchie. It's kind of like a slime color, but it actually looks pretty good. I think I'm going to keep that. So it'd be interesting to find out what it looks like as a scrunchie. So it's the next day, and today I'm going to go to Hobby Lobby to see if they have the correct satin ribbon in stock. I think it's actually 7/8 of an inch, not 3/4. So basically 1 inch wide satin ribbon. So hopefully they have it in stock. Let's go see. As you can tell from the video, there was only like 2 left, so I totally lucked out. So for your fabric tags, you're going to make a template on your favorite design software, and you want to make it at least 1 inch wide. This is 7/8 of an inch, this ribbon, so you want to make it at least a little bit bigger than the ribbon. And then whatever you want exposed on the scrunchie, I usually use 1/4 of an inch high. So the template's going to be 1 inch wide by 1/4 inch high. And then you're going to duplicate that template so it looks like this, so that you can actually fold the tag so it has part of the scrunchie pattern up here, and then fold it, and then you're going to sew it along the edge inside the scrunchie so that the only thing that's showing is the logo where it says prints and threads on this. Okay, so I'll show you on my design software, and then I'll just print it out so you can see what it looks like. I usually put a nice big strip on, or several big strips of these tags in a row on a transfer paper, sublimation transfer paper. So that's how I do it. I'll show you in a sec. So you'll see that I have my template right here. It's about 1 inch wide, and I made it 1/4 inch tall. and I have my logo on the front, and I actually leave the back just the fabric design like this. And you can put your logo on this side too. I just decide not to. I just keep it the fabric design. Then you put your designs on, like the front and back, onto an 8.5 by 11 inch transfer paper, sublimation transfer paper. And you can put like 5 or 6 columns of these tags going all the way down one sheet. And you also notice that I actually put the front part of the tag on the bottom and then the back part of the tag on top. This is so you can actually, when you fold it, you'll have the back behind the front and the seam in the right place. So you can see how small I print them. And then to cut, what I usually do is I go in between the white right here. Oops. In between the white, like right there. So I'm left with this. There you go. And then I fold it over. And you can use fabric glue to hold this in place if you need to, just until you stitch it. But what I'll usually do is I put it in the middle of the seam, and you got to make sure that your fold goes inside and that your opening is on the top. Probably be better to show you this on the table. But anyway, so you would sew that in. What I usually do first to make it a little bit easier is I start to sew my seam, and about halfway down, I'll put that tag in and then sew over it and then continue. So that's just one way of doing it. You can do it in so many different ways. I've seen some tags on the top rather than in the middle like this. I've seen them on the side sticking out. So it's all, I guess, personal preference to how you would like your tag, but that's just my way. And I like it just being a little inconspicuous, so it doesn't really show. And like I said, this one doesn't belong to this scrunchie. I just wanted to do this so you can actually see it. So it's about 1/4 inch above the scrunchie itself. Here's the finished scrunchie with the tag on. There you go. You can see it better. See, the tag matches the fabric. And that's how I do mine. I just put them on the side right here in the side seam. And I actually like this one. So here they are, guys. These are the ones that I decided to keep out of all those designs. And they kind of don't look like tie-dye when they're printed on a scrunchie, especially on a satin scrunchie, but they still came out pretty cool. And I really like this one. So what do you think I should name this? Slime tie-dye? Doesn't sound very attractive, but I don't know. So I'll put this on my website this weekend along with the others. Hopefully you like the video, especially about the tags. I'll probably do just a video just on tags and maybe show you some other designs that I put them on. So anyway, I hope you like the video and I'll see you next week.